Hi, my name is Laura, and I'm the owner of Front Office Rocks, an online training resource for dental teams, and I'm also an office manager in a dental office in San Diego, California. I am an Eaglesoft user and love Eaglesoft as our practice management software, and wanted to have the ability to help my team learn Eaglesoft better, but found that there wasn't a lot of resources teaching my team how to implement Eaglesoft in their day-to-day. So I decided to make my own. I'm doing videos to help my team get better at implementing Eaglesoft. I'm not sponsored by anyone. This is on my own to not only help my team implement Eaglesoft better in their day-to-day jobs, but now for you to be able to implement this in your practice. In this video, I'm going to talk about Messenger and how to use Messenger within Eaglesoft. It's really important that your team has a good way to communicate and a system that you use to keep everyone communicating on a regular basis. In my office, one of the things we do is we wear headsets. So everybody wears a walkie-talkie and we wear earphone in our ear and we communicate about certain things that way. But we don't communicate about everything that way. So one of the things we use is Messenger. Messenger is basically, if you haven't used it yet, is a way for you to communicate with others in the office right to their desk. So you can select somebody and send them a message. Now, I want to point out, because I had to learn this recently, that sometimes I would go to log in and I couldn't find somebody I wanted on the Messenger. That's because when you log in, you have to have this selected to automatically log you into Messenger. So what I did is I had every one of my employees log in once. Once you select that, it defaults to that. And then every time they log in, it opens their Messenger for them. It puts them on the Messenger list. If they don't select that, many times they don't realize that they're not selected or that they have an open Messenger and that you can't send them a message. So if you're gonna use Messenger, I would definitely make sure that every one of your employees has this selected at least once, and then it should always default to that. Now this is, I'm gonna close that. So this is, there's two ways to get to Messenger. One is under the utilities, one is Control M. And when Messenger opens up, this is what it looks like. Now I'm doing these videos after hours, so I don't have my whole list of employees over here. But had my employees been here, we would have a list of everybody who's logged in at different computers around the office. When I have somebody listed here that I want to send a message to, I just select the person I want to send the message to, and I say, can you please help me up front? And I can send them the message. So I'm currently logged in right now as office manager on my PC, office manager PC. Now I'm doing this for demonstration purposes. I've also logged in on Dr. Hatch's computer. So I'm office manager at Dr. Hatch's computer. So you can select the person that you want to send this to, and it will say their name at whatever computer that they're at. You can also not only select just one, you can select all. Let's say you need to send a message out to everyone, like don't forget to tell patients to like us on Facebook. You can send a mass message out to everybody logged in, or you can hit control and select different people in the list so that you can target certain people in your office. Let's say for an example, I am going to lunch and I want everyone on the front office team to know that I'll be out. I will select control, select everyone on the list, and send them a message that I'm going to lunch, okay? The next thing that I want to talk about are options. There are some options to customize Messenger. I mean, Messenger's not that difficult, but it's kind of good to know how to do these things. First is you can customize your username. What I have found, I believe that when you first start with Messenger, it defaults to what your name is when you log in. Some of my employees are numbers, some of them are initials because we used to do it one way and now we do it a different way. And when I would go down the list, I didn't know who was who. I had to kind of guess. So what we have done now is we've gone through and changed the username. So it's either gonna say the employee's name or it's gonna say their position. So that way I can go down the list and pick the employee that I want. So this office manager comes from this username field right here. This at Dr. Hatch, or this actually says Dr. Hatch's desk, that comes from the computer name. So here is my office manager PC. That actually comes from my computer name, so you'd have to change the name of the computer or reach out to your IT company to help you with that. For me, it doesn't really matter really which computer it says. It's more about who I'm trying to reach. The next thing I want to point out here are these buttons here, the displays. Okay, so first is display when an alert when another user logs in. So that's every time somebody logs in, an alert comes up. There's also play a sound when users log on. That can get really annoying because you should be logging in and out of Eaglesoft when you leave a desk or when you go to lunch. And so that happens all day long. It's really annoying. So I personally unclick these, you know, telling me when people are logging on because it's just annoying to you because they keep popping up. I do like display an alert when the message is received. And basically what happens is down here where you can see this little messenger, you know, speech bubble, it will start flashing to let you know that you have a message. You can also say play a sound when the message is received. Now, most of our computers in our office don't play sounds, so that doesn't pertain to us, but if you do have sounds in your office, we don't have speakers, but if you do, it would play a sound when you got a message. The other thing I like is you can go and you can customize fonts. Now, I wouldn't have your team spending a lot of time on this because this could be a lot of wasted time, but you can go through and let's say you want to change your font so that it comes across a different color or bold or a different size. The thing that's nice about that is these can get, when you have a bunch of logs going on, it is a continual conversation, but it might be with different people in your office. So when you customize the color, it will come across a different color. So if it gets confusing, and you guys use this a lot, you might want each employee to have a certain color because then you know who is responding to you quickly without having to look at the name. So that might just be another option for you. And of course, then you can go back to the defaults if you want. And the last thing then is to note over here, you can set up quick texts. So I can go over here and let's say I am going to lunch. Let's say I want that to always be over here so that I can quickly pick it and I don't have to type it. I can put it right there and I can add and I have it right here. These are particularly good if you want to quickly send a message and you are doing 19 things at once, like we typically do at the front desk. So let's say you're on the other phone, on the other line, and somebody tells you have a message, then you can say, where is the one that I have? Please take a message. Or I'll call them back in an hour. Or whatever you typically would say and you want to say fast without typing it, you can select here for the quick text. Here, as you see, we have backup, please, because sometimes we need some backup when we have five people standing in front of us. So you can set up quick text here. You can also delete text. So let's say I don't want to do, I am going to lunch, so I can delete that out of there. So you can customize these to help your day go that much faster because you know we have a lot going on. So my whole thing with Messenger is this is a really good way to stay connected with other employees. I use this a lot throughout my day to remind my staff to, you know, ask for referrals and reviews or, you know, whatever our game is that we're playing. I also use Messenger because I can send a message to an employee while they're on the phone with a patient or sitting in front of a patient. So let's say, for example, I have somebody checking out at the front desk and I happen to know that the patient owes money. I can send, don't forget to collect for previous balance. And I can send that to whoever is talking to the patient. They don't know that the patient doesn't know that they're getting the message. And maybe let's say the patient says, I want to know why the balance is, what the balance is for. And maybe I have a new employee who doesn't know. I can say the balance is from their deductible. And send this and help each other out without having to interrupt them and without the patient even knowing. So that's one of the main reasons that we use Messenger. Or before I go to talk to somebody, I can say, are you over there? Do you have a minute? Versus me getting up and going tracking somebody down. So that's how we use Messenger. I suggest if you use it, you have everybody log into it. I suggest that you customize the name so you know who you're sending them to. And if you need any other support for this, then I would recommend that you go over here and you go to FAQs or you go to the live help.
As I mentioned at the beginning, this is a resource that I've developed for my team, but I wanted to share it with your team because I know what it's like to be in the dental office day to day and how to make this help us do our jobs better. So please make sure you subscribe to this channel so you can see more videos coming your way. Put comments at the bottom to let us know how you're implementing this part of Eaglesoft in your practice. And if you want to learn more about how to implement great training in your dental office, you can find me at frontofficerocks.com.